Hello, Chris Menard here. I have a great announcement. My Excel online training course will be out in June of 2023. I'm about to run you through one of the review files that'll be part of the class. So we're going to cover a lot of topics, including navigating quickly around your Excel file, AutoSum, the fastest way that I know how to do it. We're going to freeze panes. We're going to create an outline. We'll get an auto outline, but we're going to have to do a manual outline for part of the data also. So let's go ahead and dive into this exercise right now. So I have the review exercise running. We happen to be in cell A1. Let's discuss navigating quickly. I want to go to the end of this file on the keyboard, Control End. I'm in cell AE41. You can tell because of the name box right up here in the top left. For me, it's above column G, AE41. To get back to the top of the screen, Control Home will take you to A1 unless you have done a freeze panes. If I want to scroll around, just scroll up and down with your mouse is easy. If you have a scroll wheel on your mouse and you want to scroll to the right, hold down Control and Shift at the same time, and then scroll, and notice I am scrolling to the right. Go the other way with the wheel mouse, and you'll be going back to the left. If you don't have a scroll wheel mouse, you can hit the Tab key. You can hit the arrow keys. You can grab the scroll bar at the bottom and scroll around. If you want to use the keyboard, it is Alt Page Down. Alt page down will move you to the right. Alt page up will move you back to the left. Forget about the Alt key. If you want to move up and down, page down and page up move you around, page up and page down. So just some easy tips for scrolling around. Now, if you notice in this file, I have products in column A, and then I've got these different regions. Scrolling over here to the right, the issue is I don't know what the products are now when I scroll to the right. And if I scroll down, I don't know what I'm looking at. You can freeze rows, you can freeze columns, or you can freeze both. Let's do all three. If I want to freeze rows 1 through 5, click in row 6, go to the View tab and select Freeze Panes and hit Freeze Panes. Test it by scrolling down. If you see rows 1 through 5, you're perfect. Click anywhere and unfreeze. To freeze column A, you select column B, freeze panes, scroll to the right. I'm just using the arrow key on the keyboard. Perfect. Control Home. I told you if you do a freeze panes, Control Home will not take you to A1. That just proved it. I went to cell B1. Freeze panes and unfreeze. So we froze columns, and before that we froze rows. Can you freeze both? Absolutely. Select cell B6, freeze panes, now if I scroll down or across, my panes are frozen. So I'm going to leave that in place right there. That is perfect. AutoSum is the next issue we have. I've got quarters 1 through 4, so the data keeps repeating in a logical order. I could AutoSum and AutoFill here, but I'll tell you the fastest way. I'm going to highlight this data first. I can either go click on AutoSum on the Home tab, but I'm going to do Alt Equal. Alt Equal is AutoSum. Check one of your formulas, perfect. Check another one, perfect. I want to check them all quickly. Keyboard tip, hold down the Control key. Don't let go of it and press the key to the left of number 1. You can do this with just your left hand. Control and the key to the left of number 1. Look at column F, those are my formulas. Just toggle that back and forth on and off anytime you want to. Highlight these totals again because I need to put them in the other columns. I'm going to copy. Control C also works. I'm in cell K6, Control V, Control V. I'm going to the right. I'm going to keep doing this. Control V, Control V, but hold tight here. Nope, grand totals. I don't want to Control V there. This is going to be our 3D reference. I need to add up all the quarter ones for that product. Equal sum, tab. I'm going to start back to the left. I like to work left to right on this. I'm going to select cell B6. Hold down the Control key. Don't let go of the Control key till I tell you to. G6, L6, Q6. I think we got one more. Yeah, we do. V6. Let go of the mouse, let go of control. Perfect. Control enter will leave you in the same cell. I could have pressed enter, but I would have moved down. Now that I have this, I need to autofill over, but here's the problem. My borders are perfect. Notice between quarter four and total, that line there, that's my border. When I pull this to the right and let go, it just disappeared. Don't worry about the pound signs, we'll fix that. To keep the borders in place, you want to use your autofill options and you want to fill without formatting. Perfect. I'm going to go ahead and widen this manually. Leave those selected, autofill down again. Another fill without formatting just to be safe. All my borders are perfect. Last one to add up here, I'm back in cell B41. Our data starts in row 6. I'm going to auto sum with the mouse this time and then click it again. That's perfect. Autofill crosshairs when you go to the right. Let go. Look, my borders are all messed up. Here we go. Fill without formatting. Borders are perfect. Excellent. All the way back to the left. There is clearly some logic on this spreadsheet. North, south, it doesn't matter what region, they've all got totals. Let's let Microsoft Excel create an auto outline for us. This is a cool feature. That is going to be done on the data tab. We have a group called outline. I'm going to go to group and I want Excel to auto outline. It's going to pick up those totals I did in F, K, P, on and on. Watch this. You should get a 1 and 2 up in the top left and a 1 and 2 vertically and horizontally. Click number 2 and then click number 1. 2 says show me everything. 1 says collapse it and show me the totals. The auto outline did exactly what it was supposed to do. The issue, and it's not even a big issue, is my grand totals did not become an outline. We can manually fix that. So not an auto outline, but a manual one. I'm highlighting column AA to column AD, still using the outline group. I'm going to go to group and I'm going to go to group. Don't hit auto outline. Notice it put that minus symbol in the AE column, which is the total, so collapse it. Now let's test it again. Click number 2 and then click number 1. Perfect. If you want to expand one of these, I'm making this up. Who is in the west region? Hit the plus symbol. There's quarters 1, 2, 3, and 4. Who is in the east region? Click it. There you go. To see them all, click number 2. To collapse them, hit number 1. It's that simple. The 1 and 2 over here is just going to give you the totals down there at the bottom. Excellent. If by chance you do not want the outline, then on the data tab is ungroup and it is clear outline, and I'm actually going to clear the outline. I hope you enjoyed this review video and be looking for my class to come out really soon. Thank you for your time. Have a wonderful day.